Well, if you got the chance to go out, say, outside late last night, you might have been able to see something similar to this. Just spectacular. This is the great view that plenty of people around the world got to see, but some might not realize the pretty lights actually come from the sun. Robert Steenburgh, a space scientist with NOAA, says this is caused by geomagnetic storms resulting from energy by the sun. While it does look nice, Steenburgh says it can also have an impact on things like communications and GPSs.
Also affects communications. It can affect long distance communications that use a part of our atmosphere called the ionosphere. And that gets riled up during these storms. So it's harder to make those transmissions. And similarly, signals from the GPS satellites have a hard time getting through the ionosphere because it's so turbulent.
A G5 solar storm hasn't happened in more than 20 years. He says the last time it occurred was back in 2003, causing power grid issues in Sweden and South Africa. We have more of our interview with NOAA over on KDVR.com. Here at home, some got to enjoy the bright, colorful light show. This is some really cool time-lapse footage of the northern lights captured by a resident in Arvada. Just really amazing. If you got any video or photos of the northern lights, feel free to send them our way at KDVR Tips. And, of course, the big question, will we get a chance to see more of the northern lights tonight? Meteorologist Liz McGiffin joining us now. And how are the clouds looking out there?
You know, Kim, I've got some good and some bad news. The good news is you were just talking about that G5 level storm, which is the highest on the scale. And that also means the lowest latitudes, including central and northern parts of Colorado, do stand a chance of actually seeing the northern lights. And of course, closer you get up into Canada and Alaska, that opportunity to see the northern lights only increases. But like we were just talking about, it is going to be the cloud cover that really limits it. Ideally, you want the conditions like what we had last night, where we clear out the clouds and you're able to not only see the stars, but a lot of that bright color from the Aurora Borealis. Looking outside now at the satellite and radar, you'll notice not everyone is getting the rain, but from Colorado Springs, pushing our way up toward Burlington, starting to get some of those heavier showers, the Denver Metro, a few light spotty showers. And then when you gain some elevation, even last night, some of the ski areas were able to see that beautiful view of the northern lights. Unfortunately, though, that snowfall out there and the thick clouds going to limit that opportunity to see color. Same story as we head over toward the Denver Metro. You'll notice Denver downtown getting some of those spotty showers, and it was earlier this evening that out by DIA we had those heavier pockets of rain. For now, though, the best opportunity for thunder and lightning stretching from Kit Carson up toward Lyman, even the Flagler area heading over towards Stratton and Burlington. The rain hasn't quite reached you just yet, but it is pushing its way off to the east as we speak. View outside with the satellite and radar, and then now the Baxton Schenker sky camera, you'll notice a few of those drops from the rain still sitting on the lens. So it is a bit of a soggy evening for most of us. And temperature wise, we're sitting at 54 degrees. And of course, where we were seeing the blue on the radar, we have those areas toward Vail Pass into Leadville, where we have temperatures in the 30s. Now, the one thing that's going to continue to limit that potential to see the aurora later on tonight, well, it is going to be not just the clouds, but those showers as well. I do want to point out, though, that it is right along the state lines with not just Nebraska, but into Wyoming, that the cloud cover does start to clear a little bit more as we approach midnight. Meanwhile, though, if you're hoping to stay in Colorado to catch some of those northern lights, as we head from midnight to 2 a.m., where we have that potential for the aurora to peak, in comes not just the clouds, but from Denver off to the east, another batch of some showers and thunderstorms. That chance for showers, it continues on not only later tonight, but into first thing into your Mother's Day on Sunday. I'll give you a heads up, though, for how much longer I expect those showers to hang around and what kind of impact that'll have on your temperatures as we get the work week going, coming up in just a bit.